Rick's not here, influx of COVID spike in Sarasota County. I very much appreciate it. And temporary hope, and we'll be able to get back to coffee hour and communion at the altar. Our worship leaders and the emergency preparedness teams are the ones who help make that decision, and appreciate all your help in trying to keep everybody as safe as possible. Our bulletins this morning are given by John and Helen Miller in thanksgiving for the property team. Thank you for your Wednesday morning services, and I also thank you, property team, for this place would not be the same without you. And eternal candle is given by Cindy Paxton in loving memory of her parents, Jack and Betty Paxton. So we continue to keep the book of prayer, and thanks for your donations for these items. Are there any other announcements this morning? I know Rick Scott and sometimes there's a few others that are thinking of things. So I think we'll be laughing and enjoying service enough that we're not going to have an official joke today. But we will gather to stand and sing our first song. This is God's world, to the tune of It's a Small World, to drive you our goal. Through the Holy Spirit, we are gifted with joy. Thanks be to God. that we may rejoice to be called children of God through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Foundation may be seated for our scripture readings this morning. Thank you, Gail.
Thank you.
answered all of them by saying, I baptize you with water, but one who is more powerful than I is coming. I am not worthy to untie the thong of his sandals. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. His winnowing fork is in his hand to clear his threshing floor and to gather the wheat into his granary. But the chaff will burn in unquenchable fire. Now when all the people were baptized, and when Jesus also had been baptized and was praying, the heaven was opened, and the Holy Spirit descended upon Jesus in bodily form like a dove. And a voice came from heaven, you are my son, the beloved. With you I am well pleased. The gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Another Disney and religion writer thinks of it this way. The moment the circle of life starts to play and all the animals of the kingdom gather before the precipice of Pride Rock to welcome their newest member, a royal member, that is what happens when we gather at baptism. When Simba, the prince of the kingdom, is anointed on his head by the kingdom's spiritual leader, Rafiki, and then lifted high and presented to all the kingdom. That is what happens to each and every Christian. When we are baptized, we are presented to all the creatures of the kingdom, and we are welcomed into a royal lineage. The creatures are the members of the body of Christ. The kingdom is God's, and the royal lineage is ours. Our claim as heirs of that kingdom, as sons and daughters of the Most High. We become members of the body of Christ and are incorporated into the church. But the baptized also share in the priesthood of Christ, in his royal mission. We share in that royal mission. We, like Simba, become royalty. We are each princes or princesses, sons or daughters of the king. But that's not the only Disney imagery for baptism, I've thought of. We could look at each scripture for today and find more imagery. Our first lesson from Isaiah is a favorite of mine. We have a baptismal banner that we put out for each baptism, and the words on it come from the scripture. I have called you by name, you are mine. As the same Disney religion writer wrote, some days will be easy, others will be tough. Even Simba had his rough days, especially when he disobeyed his father and journeyed out into the dark, forbidden an elf to bring him. His father, Mufasa, takes Simba out into the fields, and amidst his forgiveness, Mufasa directs his son's attention to the night sky and tells him all the kings of the past are looking down on him and protecting. We too will have our days when we find ourselves moving towards the forbidden, darkened land. It is during these days that it is most important for us to look at ourselves in the mirror, remind ourselves to whom we belong, the king who formed us, who calls us, who will be with us, and who will protect us from the overwhelming rivers and burning fires all along this journey of life. Now our psalm for today is all about the voice of the Lord and what it does. We not only have the voice of the Lord in the psalm, but also in the gospel. The voice of the Lord is powerful and splendid and gives instruction. Disney a ringing in her ears. It was a force that was pushing her to go on to a new adventure. She could not listen to it, which I think leads to baptism too. As Christians, we are entrusted with living our lives as sons and daughters of God. Many of us who have grown up in the church tend to care for people almost as second nature. It's just what we do, and we don't realize there could be a different way. Why do we do what we do? This voice, that's not exactly a voice, tells us, and that's the Holy Spirit guiding us. The same Spirit that was upon the new Christians from our reading in Acts, and the same Holy Spirit that was upon Jesus in his baptism, us. Now, probably my favorite Disney character is Pocahontas. You may not be able to see it, but this shirt has Pocahontas on it. And one of my favorite songs from the movie Pocahontas is "Just Around the Riverbend." I wonder what Jesus was thinking when he was baptized in the River Jordan. I've not been to the Holy Land, so those of you who have seen where Jesus was baptized, you may have a better image, but in my mind's eye, I always think of the place of his baptism as having a riverbank nearby. And if it doesn't, that's okay, no problem. Because I don't think Jesus knew exactly what was in store for him after his baptism. He just knew the promises of his Father. And no matter what was around the riverbank, it was going to be okay. Just as God never broke his promises to Jesus, God continues the promises of calling us and making us his own. We get to live out this royal life, not from a place of power or authority, but from a place of love. And that's the meaning of the song "Feed the Birds" from Mary Poppins. It's been written about that when Walt Disney would hear the song, he would say, "That's what it's all about." It was a song to demonstrate the pure act of charity. How "Feed the Birds" would ultimately come to fruition is a story in itself. It was first initiated by Walt Disney asking his top songwriters to read the book Mary Poppins. In fact, Disney had fought 20 years to acquire the rights to the book. And when he succeeded, his top songwriters found their subject matter unruly. And the story was a loose assortment of vignettes about nannies flying and on the east wind and leaving on the west. However, they seized upon the minuscule mention of the bird lady who waits outside the steps of St. Paul's Cathedral, elevating her to a role almost as prominent to the story's success as a magical name. Even Walt Disney himself raised the importance of the role by recruiting the semi-retired Academy Award-winning actress from Grapes and Wrath, Jane Darlow, to appear as the bird lady. The moral derives from the image of a destitute elderly woman at the steps of a church, asking for money to feed her birds. The simple image makes for simple metaphors, whether the birds refer to marginalized or your children. The understated moral presents itself as even more mundane because in an otherworldly film, filled with a magical nanny, made by a studio with a theme park nicknamed the Magic Kingdom, arises a problem not solved by magic, not solvable by kings or queens or fairy godmothers or a genie. The consequences are real, dark, and melancholic. The song within the plot, just as the children see their father in the bank, just as they see the old bird lady, just as their father begins to see the error in his ways, binds the film together, binds Mary Poppins' purpose, and joins Mr. Banks' inability to keeps after us and continues to say, feed my world. Feed them with love and kindness today. Thanks be to God. For our hymn of the day, we're going to sing Feed the World. So the choir is going to sing the original words of Feed the Birds. And if you know the song, the words are up on the screen, you're always welcome to sing along. And then the second verse of it will be the Feed the World of Charity words. That's a little bit more appropriate, specifically for St. Paul and the Church.
Thank you.
loved ones to COVID-19, for healthcare workers and law enforcement officers, for the prayers upon the community prayer cross, especially here at the bottom. And we pray for our members, especially Alexandra Wise, Sharon Winfrey, Bobby Wood, Ron Zimmerman, and Bonnie Zip. Our preschool teachers and students, especially Kaden, Julian, and Abigail, Mrs. Lisa, and Ms. Olivia.
God of grace,
hear our prayers.
We are joined in baptism to Christ and to one another.
Bless those who are newly baptized, and those who are preparing for baptism. Help us to be faithful in fellowship, worship, evangelism, service, and justice seeking.
God of grace,
hear our prayer.
You created each of your saints for your glory.
We give thanks for those who have called by name into your eternal grace. Comfort us in your grief and release us from fear.
God of grace,
hear our prayer.
Since we have such great hope in your promises, O God, we lift these and all of our prayers to you in confidence and faith through Jesus Christ our Savior.
Amen.
Broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, given for you. Do this
all to drink, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people, for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." For as often as we eat of this bread and drink from this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes.
Christ is God. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
So continue with the singing of the Lord's Prayer to the tune of reading and the wish your heart makes. The first time we'll have the choir singing it, and soon we will be signing it as well. And the second time, everybody will sing.
Thank you.
the abundance of your house. Send us to bring good news and to proclaim your favor to all, strengthened with the richness of your grace in your Son, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And receive the blessing. God, who leads you in pathways of righteousness, who rejoices over you, and who calls you by name, bless your going out and your coming in today and forevermore.
Amen.
Our sending song today is Can You Feel God's Love Today? To the tune of Can You Feel the Love Tonight?
Thank you.
see if we can fix it.